Shalom and welcome back to The Grim Truth. I am talking about Yom Kippur today. Yom Kippur is the Day of Atonement. Day of Atonement. It is the 10th day of the 7th new moon. If we go back just a few videos, a couple of videos ago? I don't remember exactly. It might have been the last video. I don't remember. If we go back to my Yom Teruah video, that is the first day of the 7th new moon. So on the 10th day of the 7th new moon, we have yet another biblical commanded holiday. Holiday is one way you want to put it. Some people consider it to be a feast day. Some people consider it to be... I'll try to avoid what the Jewish people consider because they don't get it right. The Jewish people add so much to the Bible that they make it impossible to keep the Torah. It's one of the things Yeshua railed on them against doing. They constantly did this throughout, I don't know. Read the book. They did it from the beginning, really. They really did. They added, they took away, they did things they weren't supposed to be doing. So many different bad things in here. Don't get me started on Christmas. I'll try to keep my tangents to a minimum and get to the point here as quickly as possible. Yom Kippur. Yom Kippur is the Day of Atonement. Now, there are a few other ways to say that. My scriptures here, I'm reading from the scriptures as always. It actually calls it Yom HaKippurim. And that, according to one of the teachings that I follow, is a pluralization of the word Kippur. So Yom Kippur, Yom HaKippurim, or Yom Kippurim, or, you know, me and Hebrew words don't work out very well together. So, yeah, essentially Day of Atonement. So Yom Teruah, the feast day, or the holiday, the set-apart day is a better way to put it, that is in the beginning of the seventh new moon, the first day, could be seen as a warning or an alert or letting people know, hey, we have this amount of time left until the Day of Atonement. The Jewish people so strongly believe in the Day of Atonement, they believe it is the only day of the entire year that they can be forgiven for any transgressions or sins they have committed against the Torah or the law of the Father, the Most High. So, yeah. Jewish people think a lot of things, just saying. Obviously, you have the ability for atonement through Yeshua Messiah. Obviously. But, there's a but. And there always is. There's always stipulations to Yeshua and his salvation. Everybody believes that they can... Well, I'm not going to say everybody. That's me misspeaking. A lot of Christians believe that they can just say a prayer to Jesus and be forgiven of all the BS that they did, you know, the week prior, and they only have to do it every day of the sun worship, which would be Sunday, in case you were unaware. And then they do this on the Sunday, and... Yeah. If you go back into Italian language and old Spanish language and Latin and go farther back, Saturday, Sabbath day, it's pretty, yeah, you'll figure it out. Sunday is a Roman holiday of worshiping that big bright ball of fire that's making me hot right now. I'm going to shut up. Leviticus 23, starting at 27. Now, you remember Leviticus 23, starting at verse 23, we went into Yom Teruah. That is the day of shouting noise, and I have a video on that. If you go just a couple verses farther, starting at verse 27, Leviticus 23, 27. On the 10th day of the 7th new moon is Yom HaKippurim. It shall be a set-apart gathering for you, and you shall afflict your beings and shall bring an offering made by fire to Yahweh. And you do no work on that same day, for it is Yom Kippurim, to make atonement for you before Yahweh your Elohim. For any being who is not afflicted on that same day, he shall be cut off from his people. And any being who does any work on that same day, that being I shall destroy from the midst of his people. Let me do that again. 30, verse 30. And any being who does any work on that same day, that being I shall destroy from the midst of his people. Okay, so you're thinking, but Yeshua is our atonement, right? Okay, let's go on to verse 31. You do no work, a law forever throughout your generations in all of your dwellings. It is a Sabbath of rest to you, and you shall afflict your beings on the ninth day of the new moon at evening. From evening to evening you observe your Sabbath. And Yahweh spoke to Moshe, saying, speak to the children of Israel, saying, and yeah, that's moving on. Because on the fifth, that's the next one, on the 15th day is Sukkot. We'll get into that in another video, but a law throughout your generations forever, in all your dwellings, forever, throughout your generations. These words are confusing to Christians, are they not? Well, we don't got to do that because Jesus said that Jesus is drinking a beer next to the fence over there too, right? He kept it perfectly. That was what Yeshua did. He came to show you how to keep it. Because he kept it perfectly. He was without sin. What is sin? 1 John 3:4, transgression of the law. What is the law? It's the first five books. It's Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy. That's the law. It's all right there. We're reading from it. The law, Leviticus 23:27, Yom HaKippur, or Yom Kippur, as it is more modernly called. Now I'm going to call it that because it's easier to say, Yom Kippur. I'm looking for something. Because I have a bookmark here, but I don't know what I was marking it for. yeah. We got to go to Numbers. Numbers 29, also in the Torah, the law of the Father, you know, the Yahweh, the Father, the Most High, the Father of Yeshua, the Father of Israel, of the God of, or the Elohim of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, you know those people? Maybe you know them, maybe you don't, I don't know. I don't know if you know them, I know them, I've been reading, I know a lot about them actually, I know not all of them were all that nice, some of them were kind of mean people. Not Abraham. He wasn't mean, right? He didn't slaughter anybody. Numbers 29. I lost my place. Oh, here it is. Numbers 29, verse 7. And on the 10th day of the 7th new moon, you have a set apart gathering, and you shall afflict your beings. You do no work. And in Numbers, it's going to tell you what you can do for the offering by fire to Yahweh. You bring a bull, a lamb, a goat, all that kind of thing. Those are the things we don't really have to do anymore, and most of us don't have access to bulls, lambs, or goats, and I don't think our local farmers are going to be happy if we walk onto their fields with a knife. Just saying. So there is ways to make offerings by fire. If you have a grill, you can light a fire in a grill. If you have a fire pit, you can do that. You can put, you know, what you had intended to have for dinner that day in that fire, you could. You don't have to, but you could. All right, getting into the important part is you are to afflict your being, afflict yourself. Now, the Jewish people are going to tell you, the Jewish people are so full of it, they make it so much harder. The Jewish people say that one word afflict means you should not eat anything that day, you should fast, you should not wear leather shoes. You should abstain from marital relations. They got a list, and I'm just not even going there. I might still have it pulled up on this. I had it pulled up on the phone because I was looking at it, scratching my head, like, what the blank, 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 blank. And yeah, no, I don't still have it pulled up. That's good because Jewish people, they do things that they, I mean, has anybody read the Gospels? And know how many times that he just told the Jewish people off for all the difficulties they did and all the things they added to it. It's just, yeah, it's just a lot. It really is a lot. And it just gets to the point where it's annoying. To me, I find it very agitating. I'm just looking through here really quickly because I thought I had another verse up saying where this was. Because there is a verse, I believe it's in either Hebrews or it might have been before that, where it told us what the affliction was, but I'm just going to go into it. This video is going to run too long otherwise. Affliction is, according to him, according to, there's a good teaching on 119 Ministries. 119 Ministries, I think it's testeverything.com. You can find their Yom Kippur video. Yeah, very good teaching there. They're going to go into the word afflict and the actual Hebrew word it came from in the scrolls, the original texts. And they're going to compare that to the word that is for fasting, which is a completely different word. So afflicting yourself isn't necessarily fasting. Now, let's not say that fasting isn't a good idea on that day. I do believe fasting probably is a good idea. It's what I'm going to do. I'm going to fast. But what the day is for getting rid of all of your humanly desires, wants, and needs. You want to just put those all aside. You don't want to do anything that you were thinking of doing or wanted to do that day. Distractions. So that is that. Get rid of your worldly desires that day. Focus on the Father and what He wants for you, what He wants for your life, what you should be doing for Him. Spend the day in prayer, meditation. I'm going to fast because that's going to help me with my prayer and meditation. It's a day of atonement. It says a set apart gathering as well. So, you know, not the whole day in meditation, but gather with people, afflict yourselves. Fast if you feel compelled to do so. Pray about it. Pray. Ask Him what He wants you to do for it. Because He's going to tell you. He'll let you know. He will. So meditation, really quickly, is a form of biblical study, really. For me, I find it for study. Because you can meditate to clear your mind, to get your brain to shut up and just distill yourself. And that's what you have to do to hear the voice of the Father. Clear your mind, still yourself, and you will hear His commands if you're listening, if you're trying to. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do that day. I'm going to fast personally. It does say from evening to evening. So the evening of, and I forgot to mention, it's going to be the ninth day of the seventh new moon on that evening to the 10th day of the seventh new moon. You can Google that. It's going to tell you it's going to be on Wednesday the 5th. Is it going to be the 5th Wednesday? Yeah, Wednesday the 5th. There's a calendar I go by on Triumph and Truth that I believe it says it's either Thursday or Friday. I know a couple people that I follow that are doing it on Thursday. You don't have to be perfect with these things. You don't have to be. There's only one person who ever did everything perfectly. He probably had Yom Kippur down to the exact second every year that he was alive. I would expect no less than perfection from Yeshua. But us, we don't have to be perfect. We strive to try to be perfect. We try to do it when we're supposed to do it. But as long as we are trying to do it is the key there. So afflict your beings. Day of Atonement, Yom Kippur. Coming up after that is going to be Sukkot. And I will be back for a video for that. But hey, this has been James with the Grim Truth. I hope you got something out of this. I hope you're reading your books. Read your Torah. Because without it, you don't know what you're not doing, and you don't know what you're doing that is wrong. You don't. Because what is sin? 1 John 3:4, transgression of the law. What law? His law. Where do you find His law? First five books: Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy. That's where you're going to find the law. And I feel compelled to do His things. It says that in here. One of the pastors that I follow that keep Torah and believe on Yeshua as Messiah, who actually reads from, I believe, the same book, he will tell you that once you start trying to do His things, you are going to receive the want-to heart. And that's the, I want to obey. I want to obey the Father and His laws like Yeshua commanded us to do. And once you receive that want to heart, then you're going to receive the power to obey his laws, to keep his commands, to do the things that he wants you to do. What else is there? What else can I say? Shalom.